My first and last name is Tim Touchberry. Well, being Barry, I was either Touch or Barry a lot when I was growing up. And then when I, you know, got into coaching, I'm like every other coach. They just call me Coach, Coach T. My case kind of goes back to 2000. I was walking down the hall with one of my coaches, and he said, "Coach, why aren't you swinging your arm?" And I looked down, and sure enough, I was dragging this left arm. And that was the first indication that I, you know, had a problem.
In patients with Parkinson's disease, there's two different reasons why we pursue deep brain stimulation surgery. One is tremor, so really bad tremor, particularly when it impairs function or when it doesn't respond to medicine. And the other one is patients that do very well with medicine, but the medicine only lasts a short period of time, so it wears off. We call these patients that fluctuate as far as their response to the medication. That's the situation that Coach Touchberry was in. So he was having lots of these ups and downs. And so the deep brain stimulation, it does for patients like him exactly what the medicine does, but it keeps you on an even keel without the ups and downs, without the extra movements or the wearing off. Deep brain stimulation is FDA approved for most movement disorders, for Parkinson's, which is the most common one that we do the surgery for, essential tremor, and for dystonia. With deep brain stimulation, we can place an electrode deep in the brain in these structures and sort of normalize the activity in that circuit.
It wasn't any doubt it was a huge improvement in my ability to stay on and not I still honestly can turn off real quick sometimes, but most of the time, going around the world to answer this one, but it is definitely better since I've had the surgery.
For Coach Touchberry, his issue was that when he wore off, he would get in trouble. So he likes to dig in the pluff mud and find bottles from Civil War. And in Parkinson's disease, when you wear off, sometimes it could be a big deal. And for him, he really couldn't move very well. So he would get stuck in the pluff mud quite a few times and had to call for rescue. So that has completely gone away.
I can't recall exactly what my first find was after I got back and all that, but you know, it's enjoyable to be out there.